Minister.
Well, I thank the Right Honourable Lady for the comments that she'd made, and I think it is somewhat unfair, given that the rules and guidance were published on the same day as the Home Secretary made the statement, to suggest that there was any attempt to conceal the scheme. Indeed, far from it, Mr Speaker. We have sought to publicise the scheme, to reach out to posts across the world with a selection of communication tools, invited High Commissioners into the Home Office last Thursday to emphasise the scheme to them. I would just like to comment briefly on the published Home Office ex gratia scheme, which was in place and indeed which both the Home Office and Martin Ford referred to when considering this compensation scheme. That provides for a maximum £1,000 for somebody who has been wrongfully deported. In arriving at the £10,000 figure for deportation, the Government considered this alongside case law evidence, where courts have awarded a range of damages subject to individual case details. We regarded £10,000 as a more appropriate figure than the £1,000 under the existing ex gratia scheme, which has been in place for very many years. The Right Honourable Lady mentioned the scheme of review. We've put in place a two-tier review. Firstly, an internal review, where if somebody is not content with the original decision, they can have it referred to a senior caseworker who was not involved in the original decision. And then secondly, independent from the Home Office, a second tier review, which will be considered with the HMRC's independent adjudicator. With regard to caps on payments, of course, this is both a tariff-based scheme and an actuals-based scheme. The Right Honourable Lady raised the issue of those who may have been denied NHS care, where the tariff scheme is an award of £500. But if an individual incurred private healthcare costs, then the actuals will, of course, be repaid. The Home Office is determined to work both within its own information, with data held by other government departments, and indeed wider individuals, so that we can help claimants establish the actual level of loss where that is the most appropriate route.